The world of design is so immense as to be completely impossible to condense in a few words. It's like the world of art. And my job at MoMA and in the rest of the world is to make people understand why it's so important. Now let's come to business, economics, and policy making. Why is design important? Because it deals with artifacts. Everything that gets produced and that gets exported and that gets negotiated upon with contracts, etc., is design. It's important for people to know that at all economical scales, design is really paramount and crucial. If you go to the scale of the corporation, it goes without saying. We have so many examples through history of how important design can be, especially when you deal with products. I mean, nowadays, everybody brings the example of Apple, but you can go back in history and look at Campari, Olivetti, AEG in the Netherlands, in Germany, AEG employed Peter Behrens at the beginning of the 20th century and had him design both the factories and the graphic design and the products. So design, as when it's really integral to the philosophy of a company, makes for better image, better branding, and also better profits in the end. Why is it also important, though, at the policy-making scale? At that scale, it becomes important not only as far as products are concerned, but also as far as the methodology of design is concerned. Many people have heard about design thinking lately. Design thinking is to design what the scientific method is to science. It's not design, just like the scientific method is not science, but it's very important to understand design, number one, and it's very important also as a new methodology and a new approach to issues that might be about social living, citizenship, even medical policies. You know, so the design method relies on prototyping. So the idea is that you build scenarios, and scenarios are based on objects. And then you prototype them, you might model them in a movie, you might just describe them in a narrative, but you try and understand what a certain technology, a certain policy might mean in terms of real life. I don't know if I'm explaining myself well because it's so complicated, but there's the world, real people, and then there are politicians, scientists, policymakers that make decisions. Their decisions have an impact of how people live in their everyday life. Designers are experts in how people live in their everyday life. So therefore, they can help policymakers and politicians and scientists prototype, describe in their mind what the scenario would be if their ideas were implemented. I mean, if you think about it, designers, when they're really effective, take revolutions in science and in technology, and they make them into life. Let me give you some examples so it's not that abstract. Think of the internet. The internet used to be, at the very beginning, lines of code. So you had the dark gray screen and then your text coming up in either whitish gray or in green. And you needed to be a programmer, you needed to know the language. In order to answer an email, you needed to type code. So it was not easy to explore, to use, even to use in everyday life. And then the first designers of the Mosaic interface, well, before then even Tim Berners-Lee and his invention of the World Wide Web, and then the Mosaic designers came, they made an interface, which means a face in between the machine and the person. And it was the first interface that had buttons, that had hyperlinks, that had windows. So all of a sudden, you and I could use the internet. So imagine the revolution. Without designers, that incredible innovation would have remained only usable by experts. And now it's available to everybody. So this is just one example, but you could go everywhere from microwaves to, you know, even magnetic levitation for trains. Designers make these innovations and these revolutions into real life.